हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com / डॉक्टर वेद चैनल। इन दिस चैनल वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग लेक्चर्स इन वेटनरी साइंस एंड एनिमल हस्बेंड्री। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर एंड हेड। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी विल डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रेस्पिरेटरी डिजीज ट्रैकियोब्रोंकाइटिस इन एनिमल्स। इन पार्ट 3 we'll discuss diagnosis, pathological lesions and treatment of tracheobronchitis in animals. Friends, we start here clinical pathology of tracheobronchitis. On examination of the blood hemoglobin, there is leukocytosis due to bacterial infection mostly, and eosinophilia is observed in allergic condition. Further confirmation can be done by the cytological examination of tracheal and bronchial fluid. Diagnosis of tracheobronchitis: the owner or the caretaker provides the history and the clinician has to perform clinical examinations and observe the signs. Cultural examination and cytology of tracheal and bronchial washings for identification of organisms and eosinophils in these washings. Eosinophils suggest the allergic condition, and organism suggest maybe virus, bacteria or parasite. Continuation with the diagnosis of tracheobronchitis: chest radiography is helpful, especially radiographs of trachea and bronchi. Endoscopy is a good tool that examination of the trachea, tracheoscopy, examination of the bronchi, bronchoscopy, with flexible endoscope. Clinician can see very well inflammation of epithelium of trachea and bronchi and presence of mucopurulent exudate in the passage, especially trachea and bronchi. Sometimes clinicians require biopsy samples for either diagnosis or treatment purposes. Pathological lesions in acute and subacute inflammatory phases: mostly the air passages are occupied with plenty of exudate. Exudate may be frothy mixed with air. If it is viral or early case, it may be a serous. Or if it is bacterial infection, mucoid or mucopurulent or purulent at the later stage. Pathological lesions in chronic bronchitis: the air passages are full of excessive viscid mucus. The epithelial linings are damaged, abraded, and look opaque. Because of the healing, there is diffuse fibrosis, edema of the mucous membrane, and mononuclear cell infiltration into the mucous layer. The tracheobronchial mucous glands and goblet cells are hypertrophied and hyperplasia. This is a characteristic of the chronic bronchitis. Sometimes there are certain diseases, they are confused with tracheobronchitis, and they are chronic pulmonary tuberculosis, pneumonia, and cardiac disease. They are required to be differentiated with the help of proper clinical examination, auscultation, chest radiograph, and other required procedures. Now we are focusing on treatment of tracheobronchitis, important topic for the clinician. For the sake of convenience of grouping and understanding, we have grouped into the four general treatment, specific treatment according to etiology, symptomatic treatment according to symptoms, and supportive treatment that gives support to the animal or vitality to the animals. Now we discuss general treatment. Important thing is complete rest is given in a quiet residence, because more disturbance and not rest, that induces coughing and uneasiness in the animal. Warm room, if available, it is very good. That gives the hot fermentation to the respiratory tract and hastens the recovery. Need not to say good hygiene and sanitation is required. Important thing is protection against sudden change in the environment. Hot to cold, cold to hot, rainy, windy. Such adverse climates cause more effect on the disease. So protection against such adverse climate or sudden change in the environment is a must. Continuation with the general treatment. Avoidance of environmental aeroallergens such as cigarette smoke, perfumes, pollens, chemical fumes, molds, dust. They induce the coughing reflex, and may cause further aggravation of the disease. So such environmental aeroallergens should be avoided, especially for the small animals, dogs and cats. Suitable management practices such as good nutrition, nursing and care hastens the recovery of the animal. Friends, now we discuss here specific treatment. Treatment according to the etiology. So if the specific treatment is not given, the recovery will not be speed up. Sometime it may not be there. So provide a correct diagnosis. Try to recognize the etiology and provide specific treatment. So correction of the predisposing environmental factors that hasten the recovery. We have already told that protection against adverse climate. There should be complete hygiene. Air must be free from the pollution. At the same time, there is treatment of the concurrent diseases such as heart disease or lung disease also causes tracheobronchitis. If parasitic infection is there, then give levamisole, benzimidazole or ivermectin, anthelmintics. If allergic causes, treat such animals with antihistaminic drugs. Continue with the specific treatment. In almost all cases, it is recommended to give broad spectrum antimicrobial chemotherapy. It is for the bacterial infection. At the same time, it will help to prevent the secondary bacterial infection. It can be given orally, intramuscular or intravenous according to the need. Antibiotics can also be given by aerosolization treatment. Along with the aerosol treatment, antibiotics can be given. Antibiotics can also be given by endotracheal injections with a great care. If there are no improvement, then perform the antibiotic sensitivity test and give the suitable antibiotic. Friends, we discuss here specific treatment of feline asthma, eosinophilic asthma. Corticosteroid can be given either oral, injection or inhalation. That reduces the secretion, reduces the allergic and secrete and reduces the inflammation. Bronchodilators that dilate the bronchi and bronchiole. The drugs are albuterol and terbutaline. Convenient is feline aerosol chambers for inhalation therapy. These special chambers are available in which clinician can give aerosol treatment. Drugs such as ciprohepatidine and anti-serotonergic drug that inhibit the development of eosinophilic airway inflammation and they can cure the eosinophilic asthma or feline asthma. Feline asthma is very common in cat. Friends, we see here symptomatic therapy. Corticosteroids are essential to reduce the airway inflammation with chronic bronchitis. Cough suppressants are required, such as antitussives drugs that contain codeine. This control the persistent non-productive coughing, especially codeine that suppresses the cough. Antiseptic inhalation with tincture benzoin or oil of eucalyptus, the hot water steam is used for antiseptic inhalation. Important and simple treatment is pulmonary physiotherapy. Here there is sodium chloride nebulization is given and there is gentle coupage is done that may loosen the secretion and stimulate coughing and expectoration. What is coupage that we see here? Coupage is a technique that is performed to clear the secretion from the lung. How it is done, we'll see in the next presentation. So gentle coupage that loosen the secretion and stimulate coughing and the phlegmon will come out. Friends, we discuss here coupage physiotherapy. It is performed by striking the chest over a various areas. The striking must be gentle but firm. With a cupped hands, the hand is made just like a cup shape, and slowly and gently but firmly strike on the chest cavity. Because of this making of cup shape hands, it is called as a coupage. Now by this technique, by performing the slowing striking firmly with a cup hand, that helps to loosen the secretion that is trapped in the lower airways and which will be cleared by coughing. So this coupage physiotherapy is simple and important technique. Continue with the symptomatic therapy. The simple thing is that nebulization in a bathroom. In a bathroom with a hot shower, it produces steam, and that can be conveniently inhaled by small animals. So either the steam can be medicated or simple warm steam can be given that is benefit for the small animals. Mucolytic drugs that liquefy little bit hard secretion or tenacious secretion so that can be coughed up very easily. Friends, I suggest here some of the supportive treatment that speed up the recovery. If the animals are anorexic or partial anorexia, inappetence, it will be treated with fluid therapy, intravenous, dextrose saline. Non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs for the correction of the fever or high temperature to reduce the inflammation, analgesics, and to some extent it reduces the secretion in the respiratory tract. Injections of vitamin B or orally vitamin B or liver extracts that increases the vitality of the animal and that hastens the recovery. Friend, this is the last presentation of tracheobronchitis. Requested to share this video to veterinarians and veterinary students. Subscribe to promote the channel. If you like, press like button. Thank you very much for observing this video.